Hi, welcome to this session on need of constraints and its type. In this session, we will discuss the importance of applying constraints during creation of tables to ensure integrity of data. We have already created a basic table in previous session. In this session, we will discuss the problems of this basic table and then understand the solution of this problem through integrity constraints. Before the start of this session, let us revise the concept we have learned in previous session. As we have learned to create basic student table and had performed all database operations, that is insert, update, delete and retrieve on it. But sadly, the basic student table created in previous session suffered from some anomalies. In order to understand these, let us move to SQL interface. This is the student table we had created in the last session. Let us insert some new record in this table. A record has been inserted. If I execute this statement again, then same record will be inserted again. You can check that there is no restriction on insertion of duplicate values in this table. It is very natural that in a table there must be some column which should be mandatory or compulsory. In case of student table, roll number should be a compulsory column. But here, if I put null, which means missing or unknown value at roll number position, and execute this statement, then again this record get inserted and it should not be. Here null or blank has been stored for roll number. Even there is no check on the validity of column values. If I insert BA as a class which is not in my university, then again this record has been inserted. There is no check to ensure validity of its value. Even you can store any random text in this column. You can also store an active value in marks column of this table. We can summarize that in basic table, there are issues of duplication and validation of data. To ensure that only correct data is stored in the database, we can apply constraints during creation of table. And in this session, we will learn how to apply these constraints on the table. The restrictions or rules to ensure that only correct data is stored in the database are known as integrity rules or constraints. There are two categories of constraints, and these are column level and table level. If a constraint is applied on a single column of a table, for example, roll number is unique, and then it is a column level constraint. And if a constraint is applied on more than one column of a table, then it is a table level constraint. For example, in primary schools, where in a class every roll number starts with 1, then combination of roll number and class is unique and it is a table level constraint. There are 6 types of constraints, and these are not null, unique, primary key, check, default and foreign key constraint. Now let us summarize the concept we have learned in this session. In this session, we understood the importance of constraints on a table. We have discussed its two type, column and table level constraint. We have also discussed different type of constraints like not null, unique, primary key, check, foreign key and default constraint. In next session, we will discuss these constraints in more detail. Thanks for watching this video.